Abby. We are from LEX2047, Group 21. Today we are going to do our fourth group discussion. So my name is Nur Azil binti Muhammad Fuzi with the metric number of 193511.
My name is Sarah Nadia binti Muhammad Zaidi with the metric number 193628.
My name is Nanhang Muhammad Zia with metric number 191545.
My name is Kasim Sanya and my metric number is 195691.
My name is Mangdu Muhammad Lukman and my metric number is 191473.
My name is Zainab Bibi Hajra Mola Hakkas. My metric number is 191567.
Okay, first we're going to recite our poems and then we'll introduce about the poet and then we can go deeper into the poem. So we'll start now.
First of all, the poem's title is Lines in Detail with All the Depravity of Poverty by Ogden Nash. One way to be very happy is to be very rich. For then, you can buy orchids by the choir and bacon by the fridge. And yet, at the same time, people don't mind if you only tip them a dime. Because it's very funny. But somehow, if you are rich enough, you can get away with spending water like money.
Well, if you are not rich, you can spend in one evening your salary for the year, and everybody will just stand around and cheer. If you are rich, you don't have to think twice about buying a judge or a horse, or a lower instead of an upper, or a new suit or a divorce. And you never have to say when, and you can sleep every morning until 9 or 10. All of it explains why I should like very, very much to be very, very rich.
Before that, I would like to introduce the poet, which is Frederick Ogden Nash, was born on 1902. Known as Ogden Nash to readers of his work, is known for his children's poems. His works have entertained children and adults alike since the creation of each work. His freeform style allowed rhyming lines of varying lengths and made up words, leaving readers a little off kilter and delighted by the inherent humor. Nash is a humorous guy and likes to express the humor in his poem. So what do you think?
So, I want to.
Yes.
Do you have anything to say about the poem?
I think we all have something to say.
Okay.
So for me, what I liked from the poem is the line that you can buy orchids by the choir and bacon by the fridge, and yet at the same time, people don't mind if you only tip them a dime. For me, what I understood by that is that even there are some kind of people who are rich enough that can buy orchids or can buy bacon, it's like something very usual for them. But at the same time, there are these people that they would not mind if you give them even a dime because it's important for them. They can with the dime they can how do I tell you? They need that dime. They work to get tips. So it doesn't matter if it's a dime or a penny or if it's like $1 or whatever. So it shows quite. It kind of shows the difference between the poor and the rich with this line.
On my behalf, what I like the most in this poem would be if you are rich, you don't have to think twice about buying a judge or a horse. It's like if you are rich, it's directly saying that if you are rich, you don't have to worry about anything. You can solve all your problems if you have money. But that's not true. If you have, and not only about true, it's not fair for some others. Let's say you have done something wrong and yet you have money against the other person, you can buy yourself out and the other person will suffer. That's what he said about buying judge and a horse, he means like he can escape from the way. So having the money doesn't mean that you have all the power. You need to think twice before you act. Because having money is just an asset and not something that makes you powerful or anything.
Actually, I like the line where it says people don't mind if you only tip them a dime. Well, it exactly refers to the rich. Because if you are rich, people wouldn't care if you tip them even 10 cents because people would say, oh, because he's rich, he has everything, 10 cents wouldn't be anything. So, but if you're poor and you give them a tip 10 cents, people would laugh at you and everybody will just stand around and cheer. And actually, poverty is something subjective and gender, and everyone is experiencing poverty. And it is either in terms of wealth, happiness, or health. And some of them don't even know that they actually are experiencing this poverty. But the global poverty is about wealth. When it comes to wealth, it's very much related to money. Poverty is a global problem, and some countries, they don't even have the money to provide their peoples with shelter, clothes, and food. So, and these problems has become, and this problem of meeting the basic needs of human has reached the point where this matter has become something that we cannot ignore anymore.
So for me, according to the author, money is a life changer and gives you the luxury of life. For example, he said about the horse, like Kia was saying, horse represents a luxury since only the rich people can afford it. And then money can help get you a divorce, like for example, for poor people if they are having problems in their home, so divorce procedures sometimes are expensive and all cost money. So if you have money, so you can easily get that. So in short, the author is emphasizing on the fact that if you have money, you can do anything. And also it says that can't sleep while having immense amount of money. Sleep here means that you have a peace of mind, because if you have money, you have a peace of mind.
You don't have to take away.
Yeah, you don't have to worry.
For me, I would like to
give an opinion about poverty, like the difference between rich and poor. For example, like in many countries like Africa and some Latin American countries, people are languishing poverty. You can see like people are living almost with nothing. And in other countries, people are wasting a lot of money on something which doesn't have much importance for. You can see like in Japan, we have a lot of restaurants for just for food, just because not to give them to poor people. It happened like 4 or 5 years ago and still happening in Japan. And finally, I would like to discuss like poverty is not also about only about money. Some people can be people in happiness or health. Like you might be the wealthiest people in the world, but you don't have health and you still have to spend a lot of money for your health, and at the end you will die one day. So it doesn't happen.
For me, from the first line, it described that you can be happy and enjoy your life as much as you can when you have a lot of money and rich. But for someone who lives in poverty, he or she could not afford to buy anything they wish for because they are short of money. For example, if you are rich, you can go traveling or shopping whenever you want. But if you are and have no money, you have to work to fill your empty stomach. And if you are rich, you can hire the best lawyer in the town to defend you when you did something wrong in the court. But if you are not rich, you don't have money to even hire a lawyer to defend you in front of the judge. And then when you are rich, you can go to work late because you are the boss and you have your employees to do the work. But when you are living in poverty, you need to go out in the early of the morning to go to work, to serve the people and to find the money to live your day. Right.
I would like also to say that the author focused on the theme materialism. He associates the theme of happiness with materialism. According to the author, money is also a source of happiness, and someone who is rich must definitely be happy. The author uses the orchids, flowers, and food to describe happiness. The author compares elites and food with poor people and how the rich spends money like water. Water is used to how rapidly it flows, so he's saying like he's spending money like very rapidly.
How rapidly water is flowing, that's how they use their money. But it won't even make a difference to them because they have plenty of
that.
But for poor persons, like they are barely earning something for their needs, so they, like it says, you can spend library of a whole year in one evening. Focusing on materialism, like meaning that happiness only comes through money, but however it can be seen that he focuses excessively on money as being the essential item of happiness in our life. He doesn't take into consideration other things like close relationships, passion or entertainment. These are all things that can bring happiness into our life, not necessarily money. Because like our friend is saying, you may have money but you may not have the all the happiness. You may be a lonely person, you may be a sick person.